slash San Pablo. Very cool history. This was a reefing freighter that was taking fresh fruit back from Costa Rica, back and forth to the United States during World War II. It was down in Costa Rica when it was torpedoed by a German U-boat. Holy crap, is that badass or what? Okay, whole bunch of loss of lives, mainly deckhands. I think 10 deckhands or dock personnel and 2 or 3 of the people that were working on the ship. It wasn't a complete loss, but it did sink, but they managed to get her refloated down in Costa Rica. So the original story, here's where this splits into two halves. The original story is she was on her way back to Pensacola or Tampa, somewhere in Florida, for permanent repairs when she floundered and sunk out here in the Gulf of Mexico where we're at right now. They said the bilge pumps suddenly stopped working, or maybe there was this espionage story where the other banana boat guys got together and said, let's go take care of the customers and we'll get rid of the competition. We'll sink that boat before it gets to back to Pensacola. So that was the story for a very long time. Shrouded in history, nobody knows where this Russian freighter thing came from until recently. So not long ago, due to declassification of classified documents from the U.S. military, the real story is even cooler than the one that everybody was told. So back in World War II, you got to remember that you're sitting in front of your television, which had tubes in it and stuff. You're sitting there, they stopped televising at what, like 9 o'clock, the American flag comes up, and then it's done for the day, broadcasting's done. And you might have had 1 or 2 TVs in your town, right? Not everybody had one. We got a couple old guys on a boat. You know what I'm talking about. Oh yeah, you see, you know. Us younger folks, we don't know. We had flat screen TVs since we were kids. What excellent thing happened was the government came up with this super top secret way to sink boats inside harbors. So what they did,
bow to stern. Not awful current, but there's still current bow to stern.
So what they did was they rigged up this small fishing boat. And they even, when you watch the, when you YouTube this and watch, there's guys sitting in a boat, dummies, waving and stuff like this as this boat, this old wooden Chris craft, is driving around. They actually had somebody driving it for a little bit, but then once they got close to the Russian freighter, then they jumped out of the boat. And then remote control, World War II here, this is cutting-edge technology, was all done by a B-52 circling above. There's a guy with an Atari joystick in a plane driving the boat looking at a television. I mean, this was cutting edge back then, right? So he's driving this boat with a joystick. He does a couple maneuvers. And then they slam it into the side of the Russian freighter where there's a small detonation, which sinks this Chris craft boat. It drops down to about 15, 20 feet where the main torpedo-like explosion takes place. It busts the hull or breaks the back of the boat, and it sinks where it is today. So the real story is actually pretty damn badass. Plus, it was sunk by a German U-boat. How many boats have you know that have been sunk by a German U-boat? So, this is a pretty cool wreck. Now, because of its proximity to shore and the pass, it was almost sticking out of the water. So, the U.S. Navy came out and had to do a little bit of demolition. Now, they got a little carried away. When you get down there, you'll see what I mean. You can't really tell that it was a ship. The very bow and the very stern has some very prominent features to it, but the rest of it is pretty broken up. Right in the middle of the wreck, there are 3 big giant boilers. The 3 boilers look like a Coke can laying on its side, and they're about 15 or 20 foot tall. And we are not tied in. We're tied into one of the 3 boilers. Fantastic. It's easy to find that spot. Okay, it's right in the middle of the wreck from bow to stern, and it's slightly on the starboard side. So if you go straight down the middle of the wreck, you cannot miss it, okay? At the very stern, you'll see the shaft. It kind of curls up and twists where it used to go to the screws, but it's in very bad shape. On the bow, there's a big anchor locker up there. And if you stick with me or James, we will take you to paradise. There's been a huge loggerhead turtle that sleeps in this cave, which was the anchor locker. A lot of times he'll sleep with his head facing out. When we get in there and take a look, we're going to be blocking the only exit. So if he decides to leave, I would highly suggest moving the hell out of the way. Otherwise, he will push his way past you. And he's got like this eagle beak looking thing that is very intimidating. And he'll show you the inside of the beak if you don't move out. If he's there and he decides to come out, slide out of the way. When he comes by, reach out, touch a shell. I don't give a crap. Can't feel it. In fact, he probably would like you to clean some of the barnacles off. But please, that thing hanging off the back of the shell is not a tail. Please don't grab hold of that. Touch the flippers and keep your hands and feet and everything else away from that big-ass head and beak. He is a little bit shy for the most part, so a lot of times he'll spin around inside the cave and you just be looking at his ass the whole time. But we've done pretty good. Last few visits here, he's been in there almost every single time. Okay? So on this wreck, which sits in about 85 feet of water, Captain? 85 feet of water. You can get some nice bottom time here, especially on aluminum 80. Pretty nice dive. If you go nice and slow, I know this sounds counterintuitive, but slow is better on this one. You can make it all the way around the wreck. If you swim your ass off, you will make it halfway. Okay? So try not to swim really fast. I go super duper slow, and everybody that follows me usually makes it the whole damn way around. Okay? Before they run out of air and panic and die. Otherwise, just nice and slow. Take it easy. I usually go down around the wreck, starting at the boilers. I'll cruise around. We'll come over to the turtle cave. We'll look inside there, the anchor locker. We'll come back down the port side all the way to the stern. We'll look at the screw. A lot of times there's a nurse shark that lays underneath that shaft. And there's a Goliath grouper in a small little cave. In